Not well enough. You need to be over there. They're over there.
Like, can I see him from the side?
Yeah. I mean, I would. Yeah. Hey, Mike. We don't have anything until the game starts.
What do you mean?
You and I don't have to do anything until the game starts. We're going to cover the.
Yep.
So I can just go there and watch it.
Do whatever you want. Yeah. Okay. After you do all the announcements, I'll turn the lights
back
on.
You took my box.
No.
Yes, sir.
Good evening, basketball fans and Grosvenor fans. Welcome home and welcome to Grosvenor High School for tonight's Northern Buckeye Conference boys basketball game between the visiting Astoria Redmen and your Grosvenor Bulldogs. Ladies and gentlemen, we live in a great country with freedoms like no other. In order to honor America and out of respect for those who have served and continue to serve to defend those freedoms, we invite you to stand and join in the singing of our national anthem, the Star Spangled Banner, to be sung tonight by Rossford students Madeline and Sadie St. Mary.
Superintendent, Principal, and the Athletic Department of Rossford High School would like to welcome you to tonight's game. Astoria High School and Rossford High School are both members of the Ohio High School Athletic Association and the Northern Buckeye Conference, and abide by the high standards of conduct, competition, and relations with member schools. The officials assigned to this contest have been selected and assigned according to the procedures adopted by the Ohio High School Athletic Association. Tonight's officials are John Boyd, Ben Blewett, and Mike Bird. Please welcome them. The athletes, coaches, and officials are guests of Rossford High School. All fans are asked to respect the effort each of them has put forth preparing for tonight's contest. We ask all attending to show courtesy and respect for fellow fans, officials, coaches, those administrating the contest, and of course, your team and opponent. And as important today as ever, please remember to respect the game. And now let's meet tonight's participants first for the visiting Astoria Redmen, starting with the cheerleaders under the direction of Coach Melissa Mason. Grace Gross, Jordan Bush, Grace Cassidy, Dakota Mason, Michaela Ray, Aaron Saunders, Ayanna Taylor, and Alina Williams. And now the non-starters for the Fosteria Red Belt, number 5, EJ Williams. Number 10, Marcella Smith. And now the starting lineup for the Fosteria Redmen. At guard, 5'10 junior number 1, Dominique Settles. At guard, 5'10 senior number 2, Devin Mauricio. At forward, 6'foot senior number 3, Avondre Reed. At forward, 6'foot senior number 11, Keyshawn Carter Stokes. At forward, 6'1 senior number 22, Jonathan Banks. The assistant coaches are Perry Buchanan, and the head coach is Tom Loomis. And now let's meet the Rossford Varsity Cheerleaders. The head coach, Leah St. Mary. Junior, Mia Carazon. Junior, Trinity Lake. Junior, Abigail Sanders. Junior, Madeline St. Mary. Senior, Madison Alford. Senior, Jordan Bolin. Senior, Allie Haas. And senior, Eileen Hutchins.
Here. we can say is wow. Absolutely wow. Welcome here to Toledo Sports Network's coverage. High school basketball on a Friday night. Mike Jamison along with Kent Murphy is going to be here right now. Just an absolutely incredible way to start this one off tonight. And we're glad that you're with us. And if you want to text us, let us know you're listening. Got to just thank all the great people that make this happen. Here's some headphones for you, too. I even got Murph was over there. What? That was awesome.
Yeah, that was, like that was pretty special.
The incredible. That people were going nuts on that Durden thing. Man. What he hit 61?
Yeah, he hit 61. I think I was there for that night. It was a special night.
Getting ready to start this one. Kroom's gonna be jumping it up with number 22, Jonathan Banks. And you've got Andre Reed out there. You also have Dominic Settles and Devin McCuro. And I'll tell you what, these guys really are looking good. Rossford, of course, has Murph, Gadsden, Jeremy Kroom. I can't see all the way over there. Is that
Gavin DeWeese? Yes, Gavin? That's the younger DeWeese.
Mr. Ben Morrison hiding over here. So getting ready to start this monster tonight.
Reed going to get the first jumper.
How's that?
Knocks it down.
You know what that means? He's always going to be known as the first person to shoot here at Rossford's new stadium. Congratulations,
well,
Papa.
The first person to shoot is not a surprise. He likes to do that. He does a pretty good job of it, so it's okay.
Not like Daddy, right? No, it's good. It's good to see him out here, and it's good to be here, and we are – appreciate all the people you know, checking us out on this. And actually, watch this. We got two cameras tonight. You like that? A little downstream stuffing.
Look at going big time.
And one of these days. But it's
oh, nice ball movement.
Just a bit outside.
Ben forgot that Reed doesn't really get up off the floor too high. So
kind of like his dad, right? You didn't have to, though, when you're shooting the threes, right?
Yeah, he's got my hops, that's for sure.
Morrison and Gadsden.
Nice look.
Oh, beautiful.
Nice leak out. That's the great thing about this Rossford basketball team. They really share the basketball. Nobody cares who scores.
Yep.
And here we go again. Nice look. Oh. Nice look by Cameron Gadsden down the floor. Ben just couldn't handle it. Looked like he might have been ready to pull the trigger a little too quick there.
I just cannot, you know, this is my second game here now. We got to do the girls game last night, and it was just a phenomenal evening. And you know, the fireworks, there's the fireworks right there.
Nice move to the basket. Tamari Kroom has no idea how good he can be. What a tremendous athlete. He's really just now getting getting into a comfort zone and playing organized basketball. He's a tremendous talent.
Hey, he's jumped into the starting lineup here too. And I'll tell you what, you know, just the stuff that he's been able to do, boxing out, keeping that big guy out of the way, has really helped the Bulldogs a lot.
Yeah, he's very active on the glass. If you watch him on the offensive glass, you'll see he really attacks it and gets a lot of second chance opportunities. Yep. Nice feed by Gaston there. Might have got bumped.
Oh,
nice steal by Morrison. That's a high basketball IQ kid right there. Jumped back in that passing lane, showed it, and then closed it out.
He has a way of being in the right place at the right time, you know, and that's like you said, it's that IQ, that basketball IQ.
It's all that time he spent in the gym.
Sure.
That kid's probably played over 1,000 games in his career.
Wow.
And when he's not playing a game, he's always in the gym practicing, getting better at what he does.
So far, a little bit of a little man-to-man here right now for Fostoria, and you know, I was talking with their athletic director as Gadsden puts one up, and
nice effort. Well done by Gavin DeWeese.
Yep, that's how you pad the rebound stats, too.
Yeah, he did a real nice job. Nobody put a butt on him, so he'll make you pay for that.
In and out. Oh, nice rebound.
Well, I'll tell you, they're going to have to make shots like that if they're going to stay in this game.
Stokes.
Another great look by Gadsden. Boy, Cameron Gaston does such a great job of pushing the ball up the floor and putting a lot of pressure on the defense.
And that's definitely what you have to do from the standpoint of I noticed the last time that these two played, you know, Fostoria got a little bit more into street ball, which kind of messed it up for them. And when they played Genoa the other night, they seemed a lot more dedicated to playing what coach wanted them to play, you know.
Yeah, as long as they stay under control, they are very hard to deal with. There it is, Jamari Cruz. Yeah,
that's why he's there.
He is so active on the glass. If you don't get him off the window, he's going to clean anything that's up there off and put it back in.
13-4 is our score right now. We got a timeout. We'll be back. Thanks for listening or watching right here on the Toledo Sports Network. We'll be right back. At Maumee Bay Turf Center, we're on your team, providing quality stadium surfaces for area high school stadiums and the preferred product of the NFL and supplier to the last four Super Bowls and the NFL Hall of Fame. Your sports field construction specialist and a proud sponsor of high school sports in Northwestern Ohio. Really happy to bring you a couple of camera angles tonight. Rich Stewart down low with us doing that, along with Glenn up top. And so far, Rossford's looking good. Murph, what do you think?
Yeah, they're doing a nice job of pushing the tempo, and they've hit some shots. They got a moving screen there. Cameron did a nice job of selling it there.
Well, the one thing, and it's always been the Bulldogs here, is the fact that there's so many people that can handle the ball on the back end of the court. And you bring Jamari Kroom in there, and he can handle the ball. And it's just huge, which I think you're going to see a lot out of your perimeter players today.
Yeah, this is a very guard-oriented, perimeter-oriented team. And that's what you get with Reed right there.
Sometimes. Gets all the way back.
He will... One possession, he'll hit nothing but net, and the next one, he will hit nothing but net. I mean nothing.
Yeah, Perry made that happen. They
good
get it
ball
over.
Movement. Tremendous ball movement by Rossford.
Probably not what you want. I would say Jamari's probably not one of your three-point shooters.
Yeah, he's not the guy that we really want pulling the trigger from deep.
You need maybe one more pass out of that, right?
Yeah, but that was nice ball movement by the Bulldogs, and they'll continue to do that. They'll probably have some success tonight.
I see Coach is moving a lot of people in today. They got Benz in now. You got Walker in there. Perry, and I'm giving some breathers because, you know what, you got another game tomorrow night.
Yeah.
And, you got Rodgers tomorrow night, and then and I'm not saying it that way, but he's got the ability to use that whole bench.
Sure, and I know he's very concerned in speaking with him about tonight's game, the emotional toll
sure.
That this game will take with, you know, these kids. This is our first home game. Nice move by Evandre Reed. Kid's a tremendous athlete.
He's somebody that's got to make things happen, too.
Another jumper by Murphy there, another air ball.
This is a big place, and it's a whole different beast, isn't it?
Compared to where we usually play, absolutely. Yeah, this is a what a great atmosphere, though.
I got to be telling you, I'm loving this place for all the right reasons because my car is parked right next to it. That's all that matters. I'm here. I have my little roost here, you know.
We got a nice little view up here.
I love this here. It works. It works.
Fostoria appears to be trying to force Rossford out onto the perimeter. And
watch the Oh!
Kroom had the block there, and nice Fostoria bounce.
Did he make that?
He made that.
Oh. I better put that score there. I didn't think he made it.
Good look by Morrison. That's one he'll usually knock down.
A little flat.
Yeah.
Not that I know anything about shooting threes.
when he starts missing shots, it's usually flat.
Uh-huh.
He gets a little back with his shoulders, and he and I have talked about that a little bit. And
yeah.
if he'll just correct that.
Oh, and he will. He's a sophomore, right?
Yeah, he's just a kid.
Hey, I want to get thanks out to Michael Weiss Roofing. I'll tell you what, a commercial roofing company that is helping us out. They're over on Main Street in Millbury. Office is 836-3028, and I just wanted to help to make sure we got these games on. Michael, dear friend, and thank you very much because it makes it all work here, and it lets me get guys like Ken Murphy in here to do color, you know. Having a ball. I don't think anybody has as much fun as you do. You just see it all over your face. That settles with the steal right there. Oh, nice behind
nice
the back.
Look. Boy, nice play. Settles with a great great pass and Avondre Reed with a nice finish. Finished over some contact there.
And as soon as I can, I'm getting you one of these. You know.
Yeah. Well, that's all right. I just got to stop fidgeting.
We'll be right back.
Hi there. I'm Nick with A-Plus Building Maintenance, your Toledo handyman. Do you need home repairs done? Not sure who to call? Here at A-Plus, we install everything from light bulbs to roofing. We're fully licensed and insured to protect you. We're also a proud member of the BBB. Please visit us online at ToledoHandyman.com. There you can see many before and after photos along with other customer testimonials and ask your own home repair question. Any job, big or small, A-Plus Building Maintenance, 419-478-1542.
13-10 is our score right now. The hometown Rossford Bulldogs on top here. Mike Jamison along with Mr. Ken Murphy from Heben, Murphy & Lewandowski, another fantastic sponsor. Thank you.
We appreciate the coverage of the NBC. It's a great exposure for our conference and for our kids.
Ponte Reed gets the old-fashioned three-pointer right there. 13-11 is our score here.
Well, Story is doing a nice job of pushing Rossford away from the basket. Playing what appears to be a 2-1-2 zone.
Yep. Kind of masks out almost like man-to-man, but those traps that are happening in the corners are really kind of giving Rossford some trouble right now.
Yeah, they're putting some nice ball pressure on the Bulldogs, and if Rossford doesn't do a better job, this game's going to be tight all the way out.
First boys game here at the new facilities, which just absolutely gorgeous, and so thankful to be here.
Yeah, well, I know as a Rossford school board member, I'm very boy. Another three by Astoria.
Stokes. That's a guy we didn't hear three-pointing from too much.
Yeah, but anyway, you mentioned the facility. Just a huge thank you has to go out to this community for supporting these kids in this school and making this thing happen. Boy, Rossford's on their heels right now.
Well, with both of these teams here, you know, a five-point lead or an eight-point lead means nothing. You know, they can knock it down so quick. Yeah, I think he did.
Yep.
I think he did that.
Good call.
Mr. Bird out there. Ben's out there. Got quite the – these guys used to all be the refs in our league. Remember them days?
Yeah, these. This is a good crew. This is one of the better crews you're going
to
see.
I would have to agree. Now, I never said that when we didn't get it off.
Yeah, pretty good defense there by Rossford.
16-13 is our score right now. We'll be back for the second quarter right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
Moe's Place, downtown Rossford, has the best burgers in town and much, much more. Stop by for their famous Flaming Moe Burger. Moe's Place, proud to bring you Rossford High School Sports.
At Heben, Murphy & Lewandowski, we deal with contested wills by breaking down the legal terms involved and making this complex area of law as simple as possible. If you are involved with a case in estate or probate litigation, we would be happy to provide you with our unparalleled legal counsel. Heben, Murphy & Lewandowski, Downtown Rossford. Contact them today at 419-662-3100. Heben Murphy and Lewandowski.
When the power goes out, your life is disrupted.
Getting ready to start the second quarter here. Mike Jamison along with Mr. Ken Murphy from Heben Murphy and Lewandowski, attorneys at law, helping a lot of people out. You do your best. You've helped some of my friends out, and I can't say thank you enough.
Yeah, we do what we can. Real fortunate to have a business here in Rossford and in such a supportive community.
Oh, amen. I love this place. You know, I've been here 10 years now, and they're going to call something inside. I don't know what.
Yeah, it's push on Murphy. He did. It was a good call. Good hands by Gaston there.
Gaston's having a wonderful year so far. Absolutely, blowing the doors off the number one or number two guy on the team, you know?
Yeah, Cameron's got a chance to be player of the year in the conference this year. Another three.
There you go, Curio again. That's another three-pointer.
I think Rossford will live with that shot. It's not a shot that they're going to worry too much about trying to contest. Another open three by Morrison. Rossford's simply not making shots right now, and they're not playing very hard.
Well, their bread and butter is attacking the basket, and they're just not able to right now.
Yeah, it doesn't help to have Ethan DeWeese sitting on the bench here, and looks like he's about to come in. Three by Murphy there. Another good look. Yep. Another miss.
It's going to be the second one on Gavin. Brother to brother right there, you know.
We got the freshman Jake Morrison coming in the game.
Packed house here, boy. This is nice to see. Packed house.
Yeah, a couple things you can attribute this to. That's probably the new facility and people being curious about what this was going to be like. And then the fact that Rossford's 13-1, that helps.
Yeah, that'll help.
Good defense by Morrison there.
Calling that, are they calling a foul?
Yep. Foul on the Redmond.
Jonathan Banks, that's his second foul early in the second quarter. He's going to have to come out. And that's big. That's big. Jonathan's a great player, played well against Genoa last Tuesday night. And I kept saying that, Jonathan Banks. He reminded me of somebody on like Star Wars or something. You know? So,
yeah, that kid can play. He's very athletic.
They're kind of hanging off of DeWeese down here. A little quick. Oh, we got a timeout.
Yeah, Rossford needs to find a way to get the ball in DeWeese's hands down on that block.
Yep, we'll be right back.
When the power goes out, your life is disrupted. Heat, air conditioning, refrigeration, phones, all gone. Want to take back control? A Generac home standby generator protects your home against power outages every second of every day, all year long, automatically, whether you're home or away. Control your power, control your life with a Generac home standby generator.
For a free estimate, call Schneider Sons Electric, 419-691-8284.
.603 left to go here in the second quarter. It is Toledo Sports Network's coverage of Rossford basketball in the new field house. Oh, that's
a great
beautiful
look by Gaston.
That's how you do it.
See if we can get Ethan DeWeese going here.
Well, that's where they need it. That's where they need it inside. They're strong and they can make things happen.
Yeah, he knocked in a lot of shots against Fostoria the first time.
Yep.
We'll see if he can repeat that performance tonight.
Deweese with the
what a great look by Gaston. Great pass.
Wow.
That is basketball IQ 101, man. That's what a great look.
Wow. What do you say, you know? There
Steal
he goes.
By Morrison. Oh, we got
nice.
Got Deweese trail in there. I thought he might try to throw it off the glass.
Tie ball game, folks.
Well, it appears to be a good timeout by Coach Vorst. He probably had some words of inspiration for them during that timeout.
You know, you never think of Brian as ever getting mad, but whoo.
Well, you haven't coached with him. Yeah, he can blow a fuse. It's a little scary when he gets really angry. Good look up ahead. Oh,
what
great
a pass.
What a pass by Ethan Deweese. Nice finish with the left by Cameron Gaston. Don't forget, that's a right-handed kid.
Wow. Beautiful, beautiful spot tonight.
Jake Morrison's really provided a spark here in the second quarter. The energy level has really picked up since he entered the game. Oh, nice look by Ben Morrison.
I think Rich Stewart downstairs for hitting up that second camera, man. It just is a whole different beast with that.
Yeah, the camera guys are doing a really nice job down there.
I'm going to bring this down here. Gatson's got two on him.
Oh,
so what does he do? He goes to the basket.
Tremendous body control right around the rim.
Oh, yeah.
What a great player.
24-19 is our score. Another timeout. We'll be right back here on the Toledo Sports Network. Thanks for watching.
Mike Jamison and Jamison's Mobile Music would like to talk to you about your entertainment needs for your upcoming wedding or special event. For over 25 years, Mike has made wonderful memories one event at a time. Professional sound and lighting and video for your special event. Call us today for an affordable package for your special day. 419-514-1302. Jamison's Mobile Music and Video.
Tanya.
Beautiful night so far here tonight, and I'm showing 23-19 or 24-19. I could be wrong, and they're saying 23-19 is our score right now. And Mike Jamison along with Ken Murphy from Heben Murphy and Lewandowski. You're not the Chinese restaurant, right? You're the attorneys, right? Heben Murphy and Lewandowski, not the Chinese restaurant.
Yeah, right there in downtown Rossford.
You know what? During football games, you got that little place out there so you guys can relax and have a nice area and watch what's going on before the big football games here. And this is our roost right here. I hope they let me decorate this.
Yeah, this is a really nice place.
This is where we need to do our games. So we're going to do as many as we can.
I think you've got the best seat in the house.
You think so? You think that's it? When I'm like 82 years old, do you think they'll put a picture of me up here, J-Mo's roost or something?
Yeah, it's already in the works.
Yeah, because you'll be like 81 when I'm 82.
Nice defense by Morrison down on the block.
You were 100% right. Deweese made
great
it
pass
happen.
Again. Boy,
yeah,
that started with the great outlet and the quick ball movement down the floor. Great basketball decisions being made tonight by the Bulldogs, especially these last few minutes.
Definitely, definitely. Morrison's got a couple here for you. And got 6 points so far. Make that seven.
Ben Morrison's got a nice stroke at the free throw line and from the perimeter. Fully expect him to knock both these. And I jinxed him.
You did. You're never playing on my Fed team again. Tell you what. And you're in good shape, and you won't come out and play basketball with us.
No, that's what happens after you have two hip surgeries, man.
Oh,
you
know? Yeah. I forgot.
Don't get out of
You're the bionic much. Man. You're Steve Austin.
Something like that.
Oh, nice. Nice.
Without the superpowers.
That we know of. All right. Just get it to Gadsden. Let him have three people on. That. See? That's all you got to do. You know, not getting back to last night's girls game. That's what Sammy McConowitz did all night, you know. She would dribble up. She'd go into three people, and they were moving with her, and she got at the foul line all night.
Yeah, that great coaching move by Toby Ledesma, getting her the ball in the open floor. You know, in the second half, they were trying to play a box and one and pick her up full court, and you just can't give a girl that's that talented that kind of space.
Exactly.
She'll end up with 42 on you, and you'll end up going home with a loss, which is exactly what happened.
Slowing it down a little bit here with about 2:20 left to go here in the half. Ah,
yeah, trying to get a little post-up action. He does such a great job of catching the ball on the block and making good basketball reads.
Oh, nice.
Good left hand again by Gaston.
He got clocked on that one, but. Just got to get a popcorn popper up here, and it would be heaven.
You need to get somebody up here waiting on you.
Yeah, that's.
Nice block out there by Ethan Deweese.
I think both teams are having trouble with their three-point shooters, I think, maybe because of the depth
yeah.
of field.
Yeah, these kids, they don't play in gyms this size with
right.
this kind of depth behind the basket.
I mean, this
often.
Is a small college gym.
Yeah.
You know, it's beautiful.
Yeah, making that transition up. Nice pull-up jump shot. That kid has been a thorn in Rossford's side for years.
That settles?
Yep.
Yeah, yep.
Tremendous player. See what Rossford's going to try to get here.
They're going to slow it down a little bit. They're going to keep the ball on this side of the court for make something happen here. I don't think they're going to take it all the way down, but no foul problems really on either team either. So we didn't even make it to 1-on-1.
Yeah, I don't think Rossford's going to play for one here. I'd be surprised if they do.
I think they're just waiting for that little boomer that they get. And eventually somebody will break down on this little – there's
– Yeah, I thought he got hit on that shot.
Reed just going right to the hole, and he trapped.
Wow, I didn't see that either.
Huh. Okay. 27 seconds left. Rossford's going to get a reset here, and bringing Gavin Deweese in. Oh, nope, missed it.
Missed it by that much.
Maybe a little bit of a makeup call on that one. I did not see the walk, but I thought Gaston got hit pretty hard down here.
Now they'll wait. Don't forget, we'll have this game for you. CW Network about 11:30, 11:45, we'll have
Jake
it.
Jake Morrison with the three. Nice look. It's all right. That's a shot Rossford will take at the end of a quarter.
24-21 is our quarter right now, and we've got a couple of commercial messages. And once again, thanks for watching this. We're just so excited to be here. I know Murph is excited to be a part of this, and it's just a great grand opening for athletics and academics here in Rossford.
Oh yeah, like I said, we're so blessed to have the community that would support something like this. It's been a long time coming, but I have been through the school and I've seen the classrooms, and what a beautiful, beautiful facility that this community has given these kids.
We'll be right back right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
Founded in 1936, Spittler Huffman is proud to continue our long-standing tradition of providing quality results and effective legal services to clients all across Northwest Ohio. We solve problems. That has been our motto for more than 78 years. Be it simple or complex, our attorneys work hard to give you the representation you deserve. We also believe in and support the respective communities in which we live and practice law.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Bin, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Bin today.
Smoothbore Sporting Goods, 425 West College Avenue, Pemberville, Ohio, is your firearms specialist. We buy, sell, trade quality firearms and hunting supplies. Smoothbore Sporting Goods can help you with your technical support for all your firearms, along with professional repairs. Call them today at 419-287-7111 before your next weekend of hunting, and check out the newest firearms and hunting supplies before you head out. Smoothbore Sporting Goods, 425 West College Avenue in Pemberville, your one-stop hunting and firearms store. Front Street Cafe is a cute, country-themed cafe located in Pemberville, Ohio. We have the best home-cooked breakfasts. Our soups and homemade pies are to die for. Our focus is to use local products here in Pemberville. Our meat comes from Frobo's Meat Lockers daily, Herzl's canned tomato products, and our perch comes from Port Clinton. We have a very homey atmosphere, bringing joy to Pemberville one meal at a time. Come hangry, leave happy. Front Street Cafe. Adler Transmissions and Brake Shop, 106 South Main, Wallbridge, Ohio. Your automotive parts and accessories number one store. Your first stop for quality transmission repair for over 25 years. Adler's Transmission and Brake Shop has been providing Wallbridge and all of Northwestern Ohio with quality service. Adler's Transmission and Brakes, 419-666-1010. Proud sponsor of high school sports in Northwestern Ohio.
Different problems require different solutions. Seagate Roofing and Foundation Services has been solving water problems for over 30 years. We have the expertise to provide you with the best solution. Seagate replaces foundations, straightens walls, lifts sinking foundations, and waterproofs basements. Get your free estimate before you make a decision, because you deserve to have all the facts. We are the local experts.
244-LEAK-Seagate. For the holidays, make Walt Churchill's Two Markets your holiday headquarters. You'll find all the tasty, sure-to-please party trays and fixings to make your entertaining a great success. We specialize in USDA Choice, USDA Prime, and dry-aged Wagyu beef to ensure flavor and tenderness for any event. You'll find a great selection of domestic and imported beers, wines, and spirits, too. Make Walt Churchill's Markets your holiday headquarters. Check us out at waltchurchillsmarket.com.
Wojo's Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing. Quality comfort you can count on since 1967. They're a proud sponsor of Genoa High School Sports and can help you with all your heating, air conditioning, and plumbing needs. Give them a call today at 419-693-3220.
Cleaning your gutters can be dangerous. Take it from Marty.
For 30 years, I've been climbing up that ladder, cleaning out those gutters. One time, I leaned the ladder up there, and the feet were on the deck. Deck was a little wet. Next thing I know, the ladder kicks out, and I'm hanging by the gutter, and I start yelling for help. After that occurrence, I called Gutter Helmet.
Call Gutter Helmet for an estimate. 419-475-0000. Get Gutter Helmet today, and you'll never clean your gutters again.
Keeping you out of the gutter.
Stop struggling with the big box stores. Choose Gladio.
Gladio Home Center. A hardware store, yet so much more. Your home improvement answer store. A place to design your interior space. A professional and friendly smiling face. Everything you need for your home. And Gladio is locally owned.
From the kitchens of Italy to you, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen is the home of authentic Italian food. As one of the oldest independently owned pizzerias in Toledo, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen has been serving since 1988. With pizza, salads, award-winning subs, chicken chunks and wings, mom's own lasagna recipe, and our famous cheese sticks, we have it all. Never frozen, always homemade. Arturo's Pizza Kitchen. Hungry? Call Arturo's, 419-698-1641. Foster Jones Langan Investment Group of Wells Fargo is a proud sponsor of Eastwood Football. Our team of financial advisors can provide a full range of financial products and services,
from helping you select individual investments to developing a retirement plan, we have access to a broad array of company resources. Contact us if you'd like to help your development for strategies for pursuing your financial goals. Give them a call at 419-872-3859. Go Eagles! The half here, Fostoria 21, Rossford 24, and Mike Jamison along with Mr. Kent Murphy, and that handsome devil Eric Davis walking by up here. I'm telling you, his beautiful girlfriend. See, I gotta be nice to people like this because they're gonna get married someday, and they'll need me to DJ their wedding. So you never know, right?
You've already got them married, man.
No, I'm a DJ. I'm always trying to get another job here.
You can't put that kind of pressure on one of my boys like that.
They look like they're having fun. Everything cool? Enjoying it here? Enjoying it? Look good? You look good? You guys take care of yourselves?
I saw him down there signing autographs.
Oh, sure.
Kissing babies. He's a legend in these parts.
Jameson's Mobile Music. Just remember that, all right? Getting ready to start the third quarter here. Hey, Murph, you were saying it a little bit that, the fire just wasn't lit. You know, the fire's just not where it needs to be lit.
Yeah, a little surprised by the lack of intensity by the Bulldogs coming out. Seemed like Fostoria just wanted to play harder than they did. And when that happens, I always try to impress upon kids, if you play really hard, you got a chance to be as good as you can be. If you don't, this basketball team's not going to have a good night. They're just not going to win games if their intensity level isn't better than the other team. They have talent, but if you don't play hard, that's a great lesson in life. If you don't play hard, you will not succeed.
I know I'm going to fly it up to up in the thing. You got Samuel McConowitz here. You got Limes. You've got Schmelz up here. I can't see everybody there. Is that Shimmings right here? I think it might be.
Yeah, that's Maddie Shimming. And looks like, is that a Burt's girl?
I think it is. I can't see very much here. And they're all here enjoying the game.
Yeah, they had it was an epic battle last night. Yeah. And there was some of the – some of the combatants over there. Yeah, terrible for Jamie Schmeltz. I'm really saddened by the news. I talked to her before the game, and she said she's out for the rest of the year. I feel for her and her family. I know what this year meant to them. You know, Jamie played up, grew up playing for me. She played with Deweese and my son Reed and Ben Morrison, and I always tell people she was my best player. So I was really
exactly.
She was a tremendous player, and I'm really I was really saddened to hear the news.
Yeah, it's since great, gonna take the whole beautiful
great game. Anticipation, showing the lane and getting out there. He is so quick to close down a passing lane. He's like a NFL cornerback closing down the gap in the open field.
And this is where Rossford can take over and, you know, get those little steals like that, and the next thing you know, you're up by 14.
Yeah, Rossford needs to get some transition baskets like that one right there.
Yep. Boy, Settles wanted that one. Fonde Reed's going to take it. He just hasn't been able to hit it. And he's taking a lot more threes than I'm used to him seeing. You know, another one.
You can't leave him open like that.
No.
Not a bad check out there by Deweese. Ball just a very long rebound. But, yeah, Vondre Reed is a guy that can change a game on you if you don't get in his space.
Exactly.
I've been coaching against him and battling that kid for a really long time, and he's a really, really good basketball player.
Isn't it amazing, though? You just know all these kids, you know, all the schools in the Northern Buckeye.
Yeah, it's
and more than just Northern Buckeye, but
these schools all do a nice job of getting their kids involved in the youth programs, and you know, the varsity coaches generally take an interest in it, and so you kind of get to know these kids from about the time they hit fourth or fifth grade on.
Rossford's defense has just been huge here.
Yeah, that's a shot. That's a shot that they will live with.
Nice.
he's no dummy.
God, yeah.
I think that was probably a really good decision by Reed Murphy there. Good luck by Morrison.
There you go.
Boy, he's not going to stay cold for too long. Got to cut him off. Nice hands by Morrison. Reed tried to do a little too much there on the break. Oh, great look by Gaston. He's going to finish that. Nice look. Very well done. Morrison's going to get the credit, but Gaston's the one that made that happen. Good timeout by Fostoria.
Great timeout. We'll be right back right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
Bankruptcy can stop wage garnishments, collection calls, harassment, lawsuits, utility shutoffs, evictions, foreclosures, just to name a few. The law offices of Patricia A. Kovach are dedicated almost exclusively to representing the people and businesses who are overwhelmed by debt. Is your debt keeping you awake at night? Call us at 419-787-2666. The law offices of Patricia A. Kovach.
Coming out of that timeout, you know, Murph and I are sitting here just talking about it and kind of nodding our head a little bit now. You're seeing a little more intensity here from the steal.
Yeah, I think it might have been a lot like that timeout at halftime there. I think Coach Vorse probably had some choice words. Looks like it's going to be off Fostoria. He kind of got undercut there. So Gaston shaking up a little bit.
Mercurio right there. He's the one who hit the nail-biter three-pointer at the end of the Genoa game. And I was very impressed. Genoa played well. It's caliber, you know. You got to look at caliber here, but they're stepping it up a little bit. But
yeah, that's Genoa's a basketball team that's got kids that can that play really, really hard.
Right.
They are never going to give up. And they've got Mikey Reitenauer, and if you got a guy like that can put the ball in the hole, it can keep you in games.
Now they're not going to be, they won't be in your in any of your setups for tournament then, right? Because you're
no.
What, Division II?
Yeah,
they're what, three or four?
They're Division III. They were reclassified. We were reclassified last year. Nice move by Gaston. Again, that all happened because of his ability to go with his left hand. Now, granted, he finished on the right side.
Right.
But he tucked it
with the left, though. Yep. That was sweet.
Didn't hesitate a bit to put the ball down with his weak hand, if you can call that a weak hand. Oh, nice left hand by Evandre Reed. And there you go, a little extracurricular talking. We'll see. We'll see how that goes the rest of the way.
They'll have the cameras on. We'll kind of show you the whole thing here. This is such a big, beautiful gym now. And you could have like a disco party in here or something. You know, Denny's having his disco party tonight. And you have a nice big disco party in here.
Yeah, this is a great venue. You can do a lot of things in here. Again, nice move by Gaston to turn that corner. Fostoria is doing a good job of forcing to the left hand, but he's a kid that can go either way, and he'll make you pay if he can get a seam.
You know, Johnny, Danforth's having his thing over at the IPS on the 15th. For his cancer and fundraiser, and I'll be DJing for that. So
well, we'll certainly be out there supporting that. What terrible news! But as I understand stories from about Johnny, he's a fighter, and
yep.
he gonna fight and beat this.
Yeah, they're looking it over. Boy, he's missed a lot tonight.
Oh, terrible, terrible decision.
Always.
Nice block by DeWeese.
They called a foul on that?
No, they called it out on Rosford.
Gotcha.
DeWeese is a kid who does a tremendous job of challenging at the rim. That's a guy that you like to have back there, that if you give up a corner, he does a nice job of getting a hand up on shooters and causing trouble around the rim.
You know, Jonathan Banks is posting up on Jamari, but he's not moving when he does it. You know what I mean? And
Yeah, I think he's getting pretty frustrated too. Nice move by Gaston. Just can't knock it in. Crazy. Hope nobody got hurt there. Both kids are okay. Yeah, Banks is pretty frustrated right now. He's being pretty dramatic over there on the bench and animated, and I don't think his coach is really, really appreciating it too much.
Yeah. That's where you gotta like just basically take a deep breath and to make it a little easier for They were trying to get that, and a little alley-oop there, but it's a little too tall.
Yeah, we did a nice job of springing it open, just didn't execute the pass. Reach in by DeWeese there.
Hey, Reed's doing exactly what he's supposed to do, you know?
Yeah, he's a very tough cover. So we got a DeWeese for Jamari Kroom. Probably a good substitution. Looked like Jamari's getting a little winded. Get another horse in there to crash the boards and hopefully get some second chance opportunities. Good charge there. Oh. Charge blocking
on
Murphy. That's one he usually gets in his favor. So he eclipsed my total career charges probably in a matter of two games. He doesn't mind sticking his nose in there and getting a little dirty.
Hey, listen, there's not many charges out there in that three-point line over in a corner. There's just aren't. I'm saying, not trying to.
It's a heck of a lot.
Just know how you play.
It's a heck of a lot safer out
there. Yes, it is. Ah, missed them both.
Good job of Murphy there blocking out. Good look by Gaston. Good finish by Morrison.
Wow, that's strong.
You know,
that is strong.
He's deceivingly quick with that first step. You know, but problem is you when you get in transition like that, you got to run out on top of them, and when you do, there's every chance your momentum's going forward, his is going to the rim, and he's going to blow by you, and he's real good at finishing at the rim.
Thirty-five, 23, 2:13 left in the quarter. There you go. No foul.
Good
there.
Steal by Gaston. Ooh. Good steal by Gaston. Nice challenge there at the rim.
It's gonna get a little ugly, I think.
Yeah, every time Rosford plays Fostoria, it gets a little bit chippy. You know, the truth is that's what you get when you have a bunch of competitors on the floor.
Right.
These kids scrap just like the Rosford kids do.
I can tell you, though, Gaston's had some trouble at the line here in the last couple of games.
Yeah. You know, I think it's more mental than anything. I've taken a hard look at his mechanics. And nice finish. I think he considered tossing that over to Deweese and letting him try to tear the rim off, but probably made a good decision going ahead and knocking that in. Another good steal by Gaston. Oh, almost steal.
Oh,
didn't see that one either. You know, that's one thing about Fostoria is they, a lot of times if they get a little rattled, they will lose their composure.
That's what's happening.
Yeah, when you push them out of their comfort zone, they get a little excited, and sometimes they try to speed it up a little too much. See Reed, they're trying to push Gaston to the left, and again, that's just not a good pass.
Staying there, let's stay here. Gaston kept his hands off that, and I think Banks was all over it for Fostoria. Special thanks once again to that MJ Weiss Roofing Company. Commercial roofing at its best. They're right here, a local company, Millbury.
Oh, nice look. Love the lack of hesitation by Morrison. That's been something throughout his career that has been, I know, concerning for the coaches. Again, nice move to the rim there, but Ben Morrison has got to be aggressive offensively if Rossford's going to be the best team that they can be. I love that look. That's okay. That's not a bad shot. I like the fact that he's being really aggressive with the basketball. Good call. That's right.
He was moving.
Look, yep. He was not in position.
He was really moving when he got hit.
He went
back like a crash test dummy there.
I think Cameron got the worst part of that.
All I know is if I would have done that, the floor would still be shaking. You know?
Now we got Luke Borovich coming in the game. Kid that can really play basketball. Maybe the highest IQ on the floor outside of probably Gaston. A kid can really, really play, and he's only a freshman. So he's got some really great years coming.
Watched him in the JV game. They played... I don't even want to say what the score was.
Yeah, it was ugly. That funny thing about it is that JV team for Rossford is all freshmen with the exception of Gavin Linkus. Oh, good look by Gaston.
And then he fouls.
Good look by Gaston. And got the ball up the floor to Kroom and just couldn't handle it cleanly and get to the rim.
Every once in a while, them things get a little crazy. Better now? Here, I'll get it for you. This is the thing that gets kind of a little
having
better.
Some technical difficulties here.
Settle's going to bring it all the way up. You going to hear it now?
Right. Much better. Good luck.
Boy, Settle's just hasn't been able to do it.
Rossford's really kind of lucky that that Fostoria is not really hitting some pretty good looks.
Exactly. Hey, we got a couple of them for you here.
Take a minute to recognize Rossford
At Heben, Murphy & Lewandowski, we deal with contested wills by breaking down the legal terms involved and making this complex area of law as simple as possible. If you are involved with a case in estate or probate litigation, we would be happy to provide you with our unparalleled legal counsel. Heben, Murphy & Lewandowski, downtown Rossford. Contact them today at 419-662-3100. Heben, Murphy & Lewandowski. Wow, Brian Williams got himself some buckaroonies tonight. That's a good thing. Oh, I got no, that's me. There you go. I'm sorry.
That's just what he needs. More golf money.
That's okay. That's okay. We'll get out there and do some golfing. You know, I haven't golfed with you. I don't think I've ever golfed with you, have I?
No. No, we've
had the pleasure going out with your
keep
sons.
Telling me you're going to invite me to one of those nice courses you do your show on.
And yeah, we'll get you out there. Gadsden.
Nice take by Gaston, but he drew two and the ball didn't come out. That's
George Gerwin, the Iceman. Every time I see him play, he reminds me of the Iceman.
Yeah, boy. Really got to – really need to put a butt on somebody there on the glass if Gavin DeWeese doesn't do it. You know, their Fostori is very active, and they will beat you on the offensive glass.
Yep.
Really struggling from the line here. Banks gets the second one. See if Rossford can get the ball movement going again and get some better looks than we've been getting down on their offensive end. Run a little backdoor play. Need to get it out of that corner. Good kick out to Murphy for three. Good clean look. Again, just not knocking shots.
Turn my mic back up there.
Andre Reed tried to lean in there and draw the foul. Nice pass again by Cameron Gaston. Good look by Jamari Kroon getting the ball up the floor. Boy, Rossford's having a lot of success when they get the ball up the floor on the pass. If they'll continue to do that, they'll probably like the outcome of this basketball game. I apologize. We have some technical difficulties here.
Oh, no technical. Just normal. Just JMO stuff. Right.
Jameson difficulties.
Yeah, Jameson difficulties. It just happens all the time that way. I just want to make sure people can get to see what the time clock is, and my battery went out on it. So now it should just – there it is. I'll be darned we got a time clock again.
Nice work. Mike the engineer.
Yeah.
Oh, bad foul.
That's the stuff you get a little nervous about, you know. And
yeah, that's the kind of stuff that drives you crazy as a coach. Settle's just leaned in. Kid's only a junior. Can really play. I think he's been starting since he was a freshman. Just a heck of a player.
Total fouls. Both teams are with six here in the second half. And
this is Rossford's normal starting five since Borovich went out. So,
and what happened?
That was the when he transferred over Ohio High School Athletic Association.
Oh, he can only do
sit out. Yeah,
right.
So you have
13
to sit out the second
games.
Half.
Yeah.
Yep. Well, oh yeah, that's a good call. Slap down on him. You're going to get that call 9 times out of 10 if you slap down like that.
Personally, there was a foul before that foul. If I'm, you know,
that that's the one that never gets cut. It's always the second one they get, you know.
Yeah, I don't think anybody can really complain about how these officials are calling the game.
No, absolutely not. Keyshawn, Carter Stokes, and these guys are still struggling to get that ball in the hole.
Oh, yeah, Stokes is a nice athlete, but turns out it's a pretty good foul.
Didn't get either of them.
Vondre Reed's doing a good job of Murphy again for three. Boy, missed another one. Again, struggling. Struggling to make shots.
Well.
But a good look. Great kick out by Gaston. He's just not knocking shots in.
Beautiful haul. Trying to show you a couple angles of it here tonight.
Another good kick out by Gaston.
I think
Rosford, no. Rosford is going to struggle if they don't hit open shots, because Fostoria is doing a really good job of forcing him to kick the ball out. They're doubling everything in the paint and doing a great job of he's doing a great job of kicking it out. And Rosford's just not knocking shots.
Well, it took him a while there, but Jonathan Banks got that one. We're under 9 points now.
Yeah, again, Rosford's just gone stagnant all of a sudden. You do not want to let a team like Fostoria stay in the game.
Absolutely no way, right.
Great pass.
Now they're moving the ball now.
Good ball movement. Now Fostoria is just trying to keep the ball out of Gaston's hands. Cameron's got to be real careful not to fall into the trap of trying to force it,
right?
Because his guys aren't making shots. He needs to trust the guys around him, which he's done all year, and he'll be all right. It's a nice substitution, bringing Morrison for Murphy. Reed's not hit a lot of shots tonight, and he looks a little off balance, and looks like Coach Vorster is letting him know about it.
Out of bounds. It's Fostoria ball right now. 5:01 left to go.
You can see here when the ball's away from Morrison, he's making a concerted effort to stay out on top of Reed, which is going to open the right side of the floor for Settles, and you're going to get that kind of play right there.
Promise it'll be fixed before you ever do that again, okay? All it is that little gold piece right there is just a piece of junk. Nothing wrong with anything anywhere else, and I've got 100 of them, and I can't fight them. They still can't make their foul shots.
Good look by Gaston. See if Morrison can finish it the rim.
Of course
nice
he does.
Look.
Even when he throws it up there, he throws it upright.
Yeah, that's not the first time he's taken that shot. I can guarantee you that. Kid spends a ton of time in the gym, and these are the kind of results you get when you do that.
Yep.
If you watch close, when the ball's away from Ben Morrison, he's staying right on top of Vondre Reed, really trying to keep the ball out of his hands. They're not quite face guarding him, but they're certainly shading, because Rosford puts a lot of emphasis on getting to the middle of the floor when the ball's away. So you can tell they're trying to keep the ball out of Reed's hands.
That's a good make.
Yeah, Banks has struggled a little bit here from the line. That was a good one for him to get. See if he can settle in a little bit here.
There you go. Couple of them. 10-point game.
Well, they're going to turn the heat up. See if they bring some bring a double here on Gaston. Yep, there it is.
Oh,
that was a right read. Ben just was not expecting that pass. Good read by Cameron Gaston. As long as he's getting doubled, he needs to continue to make good decisions, and Rosford will be just fine.
favoring that knee a little bit right there. He Stokes got up a little gingerly. I think that's a word I want to use tonight, gingerly.
Yeah, it's interesting. These kids are all about the same height, about 5'10", between 5'10 and 6'1". They all have similar games. They're very athletic, and you absolutely have to keep them off the glass. If you don't, you're going to have a rough night, and they've been able to close the gap by being active on the glass. There you go. See, Rossford's really uncomfortable and gassed and can't get the basketball. Here'll come the double team. And they're staying on top of Morrison as well. Looks like now they're face guarding Morrison and Cameron Gaston. Look for DeWeese or Jake Morrison to spring open here for a jump shot because of the way that they're defending. That's a good call. Might have got hit, but it was a good call. Boy, the crowd didn't like that one much. Good defense by Jake Morrison. Again, playing against guys a couple years older than him. Good move by Suttles. Uh-oh.
Got him.
Yeah. Bad turnover by Gaston.
Oh,
that was a little surprising that whistle wasn't blown a lot quicker. I'm not sure if I've got a sound delay here or what. My goodness. I mean, I learned my first year of law school. That's an assault in about 48 out of 50 states. Yeah, I'd just like to send a shout-out to Tommy Kralovic, a former Bulldog who is being inducted into the Hall of Fame this year, one of the best players that I ever coached. And Tommy wasn't the most gifted kid, but he was a kid who would absolutely bust his butt every day, and if the gym was open, he was in it.
I agree.
So I was really fortunate to be able to have a few years with Tommy and his father, Tom.
I used to play. Oh, nice. How about that Stokes kid?
Nice finish there by Stokes under some duress.
Five.
Boy, Rossford is nice look by Gaston.
No look.
Real nice look by Gaston. Boy, Rossford needed that one. Murphy's working real hard on the defensive end here. Good defense. Gotta catch that. Oh, good look by DeWeese. Tremendous. Nice finish by Cameron Gaston. Boy, just like that, Rossford brings it back to 9. Give him a little bit of a comfort zone here. We'll see what happens.
Yeah, we're staying here. So nice to see this place packed. Hopefully we can keep it this way all the time. It's just such a wonderful, there's just so much good athletics that are coming out here in Rossford right now. And, boy, I'll tell you what, green light all the way around.
Yeah, we, you know, there's a very rich basketball tradition here at Rossford. And that's something that I know Coach Forrest and Coach Morris and Coach Kralovic are doing a really good job of trying to reach out to former players and get guys back and make sure they're included in the program as part of the Bulldog family. So it's really nice to see the community come out and support, and it's really nice to see a bunch of former players. If you ask some of the old timers here, you know, they'll talk about how these games used to be packed. Just like tonight is.
Oh, that was smart.
Yeah, that's bad.
Reed did a nice job there.
Yeah, it looked like Vondre Reed might have initiated that contact, but Ben was hugging him a little bit. And, you know, Reed's not going to miss a lot of free throws. Kid's got tremendous touch.
Right.
Rossford really, nice. Rossford really can't afford to send them to the line and stop that clock.
That's what
good
he
take
needed.
By DeWeese. Good decision. Good look. Rossford just can't finish it.
We're at the 2-minute mark right now. 8-point game. Rossford's still on top.
Yeah, Rossford's. You know, if they can hold on here, they've really dodged a bullet. Because, you know, Fostori has not shot the ball real well, especially here in the second half. Another really clean look for Fostoria.
What did we miss here?
Ball hit the top of the window.
Gotcha. I'm sorry, I missed it.
Looks like Vondre Reed and Reed Murphy are going to get a little tied up there. That would not be the first time. Now Ross, we're just going to spread them out and bleed this clock a little bit, unless they can get something on the glass. I'm sure Coach Forrest is telling the kids that they're not going to do anything other than bleed it and put the ball on the glass and keep the ball in your ball handler's hands, Cameron Gaston. Nice post up by DeWeese, being real strong in the paint there. Got to get out of that corner. You can't let the smallest guy in the gym get trapped like that.
Right.
Oh, Kroom missed Morrison there. DeWeese found him. And see if we can get three the old-fashioned way for Ben Morrison. Really nice look by Ethan DeWeese. Again, that's one that Ben Morrison's going to be on the highlight, and Ethan DeWeese made that happen. Yeah, I think this game's been a little closer than Rossford expected.
Not that time.
Vondre Reed, nice
block.
Move. Boy, I thought, good thing we're not down on the floor where they can see a replay, because that that came right off of Jamari Kroom. Boy, look for Rossford here. They're going to. I was thinking. Oh my God! Vondre Reed just absolutely forearms Jamari Kroom. Wow. I mean, like in the chest. I'm really in there. They're continuing. I'm really surprised the officials aren't putting a stop to that.
Let's stay here. We got all the right. I do want to say thanks once again to Michael Weiss. Weiss Roofing, and they are the best in the area. Yeah, you know, they're contractors. They work with all the commercial buildings here in the area, and Michael's been a fan of what we've been doing for years and has been helping us out. And their phone number is 419-836-3020, and they're on Main Street in Millbury. And Mike's here watching the game tonight and enjoying it like everybody else is. It's been a good game.
It's been a great game. What an electric atmosphere.
Got another one tomorrow.
Yeah. Yeah. The Bowser Rebels coming in.
Is this Bowser night or is this Rogers night?
Tomorrow night's Bowser.
Okay.
Rogers is coming up on February 8th.
Yeah, next Saturday.
Bowser will be long, athletic. We'll challenge everything at the rim. We'll speed the game up and it'll be one of those games. If Rossford can control the tempo, they should have some success. They're going to need to just get the basketball in bounds here. Wow. Man, I'm really surprised by the amount of contact they're allowing to happen on both sides.
Huh.
Lot of contact.
Reed's
you can tell Reed is to the point now.
Yeah.
He just goes
got to shoot.
Yeah. He's decided he's going to go ahead and take over this game. and he's capable of doing that. He's a very good basketball player. My, a lot of contact again.
Three of them. Three of them that time. Three.
Yeah, that was.
They got him on the last one, you know. It's,
boy. Being from Oklahoma, I know when somebody needs a saddle. I think Cameron Gaston needed a saddle there because he rode him all the way from half court down. This is a place where Cameron Gaston's got to improve.
Oh yeah.
He's a guy you got to have the ball in his hands late because he doesn't turn it over. He makes good decisions. But boys, he's just struggled down the stretch at the free throw line, which is strange because he's got a nice stroke, pretty good mechanics. And again, I think it's
a mental issue. Last year, did he?
No, not at all.
I mean, he really kind of popped it last year. And
Vondre Reed again, going to try to take control of this game. And yeah, Reed Murphy, if he was wearing a red jersey, that would have been a foul on Reed Murphy, taking Gaston for the to the floor. Looked like Murphy got 2 points for a takedown there. Oh, nice block by Gaston.
They're laughing at each other.
He's letting Settles know that the little guy in the gym just got you. that was an interesting exchange between those two guys.
I'm sure they all are. They're good friends, right? They will be.
Yep, they've all been competing for a long time against each other. Nice defensive play. Yeah, another foul on Reed.
Wow. We're at 1 hour and 40 minutes into this game, and I got to make this 1 hour and 13 minutes and 30 seconds.
Yeah, you'll. You'll need to do a lot of cutting me out, especially that part where people could actually see what I look like.
Again, Rossford just can't make them.
Rossford needs to make sure that they're not letting Fostoria score at the line. That's
right.
That's really the only way that they can win this game is if they're scoring when the clock stopped. Looks like Rossford's going. My guess is, I think on the next one you're probably going to see Rossford. Go over the top. One of the things I know they look for on that inbound is if that backside guy's not there, they'll try to send somebody over the top, break him free, maybe see if they can get the loose for a dunk.
Not even bringing anybody up there.
No, I think I think Rossford's in don't do anything stupid mode here.
Is that what they call it? Is that the name of it?
yeah, that's the technical term. Kroom gets one of two there. Rossford's gonna have to get better at the line if they wanna challenge really good basketball teams.
Is it staying here? Yep. 15 seconds. At this point, you let them do whatever they want, right?
Just don't let anything silly happen. Gaston looks like trying to make a play. Oh, boy. We got some fireworks here with Cameron.
He was going all the way. He was in there. Yeah.
They're just going to hold on to it and let the clock run out. Wasn't a pretty win, but the Bulldogs prevail on opening night here at Rossford's new high school.
Oh, that's beautiful. And, Kent, thank you very much. We're going to have to cut this one short because we're way long on this game. But I want to thank Rossford for making such a beautiful place right now. Great folks like you and Heben Murphy and Lewandowski for helping us out. Of course, Rex Huffman and of course, Morrison with Maumee Bay Turf and Harpo. Can't forget Harpo, man.
Oh, how do you forget Moe's?
I know. Thank you for all the great things. We've got a lot of Rossford basketball coming up next week. And, guys, Glenn on camera and Rich on camera did a wonderful job tonight.
Yeah, great job to those guys. And just like to say thank you to Toledo Sports Network for doing such a great job of covering the league and our kids.
I appreciate that. That's why we do it. We love it. We got to wrap this one up. We're done. Your final once again tonight, 53-46. Rochford Bulldogs on top of the Fostoria Redmen. Take care, folks.